The grandstands are full to capacity, and it's no surprise everyone is really excited to see what's going to happen in the German Grand Prix this weekend at the Hockenheimring. With average lap speeds of around 130 miles per hour, the Hockenheimring is a quick circuit with a lap distance of 2.8 miles, around 17 corners. The main DRS zone through Parabolica leads into the hairpin for the best overtaking opportunity on the track. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as we anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position with Charles Leclerc alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Bottas, Alexander Albon and Magnussen, Hülkenberg, Perez, Raikkonen and Carlos Sainz, Stroll, Ricciardo, Lando Norris and Gasly, Kvyat, Grosjean, Antonio Giovinazzi and Robert Kubica, Russell and Lewis Hamilton rounds off the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Nice move.
entering lap 3 now. DRS has been enabled. Top 10 now, keep it up. Our gap to the car in front is 1.5 seconds. We'll be right back. Valtteri is in for his stop. You're catching the car in front by a second per lap. Safety car deployed. Slow down and maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is deployed. Drop your speed. Our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. we're going green, maintain positive delta until the green flags. Complete, go now. Stop today. One stop left in our strategy. That's a new fastest lap for the race. was reckless. We're lucky not to have been penalised. The gap to the car ahead is 6.2 seconds. Slowly gaining on the car in front. Try to keep this momentum. Stopping now. Front is 4.6 seconds. be on the mediums. We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. Seconds. Second faster than the car ahead. Keep this up. Valtteri is in the pits. Pit window open. Let's box this lap. In this lap, and remember the speed limit. We'll be penalized if we exceed it. Keep that in mind as you approach. After these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. fuel settings, we won't have enough fuel for the end of the race. Consider lowering the fuel mix. Is 2.1 seconds. This lap of the race, keep this up. We'll be right back. plus one lap of extra fuel. Fuel target plus one. Is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. scraps of fuel remaining. Awesome. Just amazing. Well done.
And Mercedes have pulled off a great victory here today. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, when you overtake that many people, I'd certainly hope you'd win the race. Their car was really effective in the slipstream here today, and the team would be pleased that they didn't cook the engine, given how long they were spending in the hot air behind other cars. They had a lot of confidence to push their tyres hard as well, especially going into the corners, which allowed for some late braking and some exciting passes.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
It's got to be Lewis Hamilton. I mean, he pulled off some impressive feats out on the track today, even by his standards.
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.